That was weird.
Motivational music for
you. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I had a couple guys come in, and they want a couple graffiti style shirts. So, here we are. Already finished the first one. Working on the second one. So what I'm doing now is I'm kind of just putting the letters in where I want them. Really, really lightly. I'm going to come back and, as Brian would say, I'm going to chisel it.
Chisel.
Like shiz, but not really. More like chiz.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay. The name is Martin. I don't have any, like, predefined anything, really. Just kind of going with the flow here. See what happens. I want to make it legible. That being my first priority. Although it's graffiti and you might not want it to be legible on a shirt, you do.
So what color are you using right now?
I'm using E-Tech paint transparent gray. Now this section here, if you notice, like, I don't know if you can see this or not, but the letters kind of were slanting down the shirt as I was painting them. So to bring your eye back down, I pulled it through this little loop-de-doo back in there. And if I want to fill it up even more, I'll throw one of these big old-school arrows in it. And this I can just fluff out with color when I'm done, like so. And this will keep the whole overall composition going. So I feel pretty good about my general sketch. Now I'm going to come back in with my black. This is an opaque black. I'm going to chisel this. Now my goal here, I think the shirt's only about 18 bucks, so I really only want to spend probably 5 to 10 minutes on it, really not a lot of time. So. The goal is to be as quick as possible, but still make them look like, you know, they got their money's worth. I don't want a chintz. Don't want it to be cool. But I don't want to go overboard either.
Something flavor for a little sweet savory. I can't see you. Delicious chicken sandwich. Together, our
I find that it helps to make sound effects when you're drawing. Now what I'm going to do is, I've solidified the lettering. I'm going to come in and really do like a hard outline drop shadow sort of deal. Like if I want my drop shadow on this side, so all of these lines are going to be thick and bold. So everything on this side gives a lot of gas. I don't want it to be fuzzy, I still want it to be tight. I'm staying pretty close to the surface. But I want it to be thick. Without having to go over it a bunch of times. I could, theoretically, draw it in first. And then fill it in. Like so. But I'd rather not. I'll sacrifice the sharpness for time. Some of these open areas I'm just going to fill in, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Let them work themselves out later.
You got 3 minutes and 30 seconds.
3 minutes in?
You're 6 minutes and 30 seconds in.
Oh, yeah. Second section will go pretty quick. Alright, I'm going to switch colors again, put my fill in.
What's up, guys?
And all these lines, you notice I'm just drawing right over everything. It's kind of like a plaid look. We've gone plaid.
You got 1 minute.
Training video you got going on? Yeah.
It's for YouTube.
Oh, say hi to all the YouTubers.
So say hi, Dave. They can hear you.
I noticed he painted one earlier for himself that you know how to dress it.
Nah.
Supposedly, HMIC has my partner in charge.
That's right.
All
right, buddy. Done and done.
Done and done. I could highlight it. I don't know. How much time do we get? Done?
You've got 20 seconds.
Oh, shoot!
I want to see 20-second highlights. Four.
Three. Two. Yep.
There it is.
There it is, done and done. That's my version of a quick graffiti style t-shirt, 10 minutes or less, and, you know, easy $20, including the shirt. And that's how we roll. Battle Creek. Waffle out.